A harsh winter season has been predicted for Mississippi following the heat of summer. At the North Mississippi Grazing School in Verona, cattle producers learned about tools to help them plan now and get the most out of their pasture and hay systems. FarmWeek's Amy Taylor reports.
Mississippi State University Extension Service specialists say thinking ahead is the name of the game in cattle and hay production. Durwood Gordon explains what he learned about adapting rotational paddocks to extreme weather conditions.
When you have 102 degree temperatures and no rain falling, yeah, the challenge is how do you keep that grass growing? And that's one of the things we learned today. By doing rotation through these different pastures, you can keep your pastures lasting longer with a higher quality. He talked about stock density, how many cattle putting on a paddock, the size of the paddocks, how to determine the size of the paddocks, do the number of cattle you have.
To do this, producers learned how to use a tool called a grazing plate meter to estimate forage production and how many days they can maintain a herd in a specific pattern. MSU Extension Service forage specialist Rocky Lemus explains why it's helpful.
This is helpful because it allows producers to determine what is the grazing capacity that they might have at a specific pasture at a specific time during the growing season. If the grass is too short, they might opt for letting that pasture to rest for a longer period and move the animals to a pasture that might have more forage available.
Lima says this method can generate an efficient forage system and cattle herd and could save money. He also says proper electric fencing is easy, fast, and affordable for rotational grazing. Furthermore, the take-home message is to prepare for a harsh winter.
Be efficient about using fertilizer in your pastures, in the hay system. Maintaining the quality of the hay is very important. That will save a lot of money on feeding costs during the winter. So knowing how much nitrogen do you need, what is in the soil, soil testing is a very important part of that system.
Lemus recommends producers contact the MSU Extension Service for a soil test. From Verona, Mississippi, I'm Amy Taylor reporting.